in ISKCON these days, devotees around the world, they get transcendental knowledge, information, education, lot of. There is plenty of knowledge, education, information, everything. All over the world they get. And especially in educational institution like this, where throughout the day we get knowledge. Yes or no? Yes, Tirumalabhu? Throughout the day we get knowledge, information. So what happens that in the society or in any educational institute, when you get the knowledge and so much detailed knowledge and information, so it remains in the head. It remains in the head. And anyone can say, if someone asks, then it can come out also. It remains in the head and it can come out. It can be repeated. It can be said. So if someone asks anything, then many devotees, very scholarly devotees, very intellectual devotees, they can give different angles, discussion, different techniques of how to understand a subject matter, far superior than any one of us. Isn't it? Anyone can understand. So the point is that we appreciate their intellectuals. They have given God-given talents, memory and motivational speaking, all these qualities are wonderful, and they are using in the service of the Lord. But the point is that if I have been given a topic, we memorize and we remember and we vomit and we write down. So exam point of view, to get marks also, it's also good. We are not against of this, and this is one of the main aim of the institute, that all the devotees should read thoroughly, understand and memorize and appear in the exam, and most important is pass in the exam. So that is all there. So my dear devotees, the point what I am mentioning is that, what I am going to say is that, we generally get so much information and knowledge. Just like the example what I say is that, if someone is given a topic, say something about humility, I can speak 2 hours on humility, right? All the examples, connecting examples, technical points, stories, analogies from different Puranas and different current situations and practical situations, that we can discuss. Any one of you can say like that. So just today's world is information world, and next to God is Google. Am I right? Next to God is Google. You just type a word, you get lot of information, and a lecture can be given. But at the right moment, when someone insults us, how do we react? Just think for a moment. Some unfavorable situation comes. If someone says something, how do we react? How do we behave? And do we have the tolerance power? Or say we reply back, right? Reply back. Or say something against, or sometimes the devotees have revengeful attitude. Oh, he said something like that. How dare he can say like that? And then where is that 2 hour humility lecture is gone? Isn't it? So it's there. I can repeat. If just switch on the button and I can repeat. Anyone can say. So the point is that the same knowledge, head knowledge, has to transfer to heart knowledge. Knowledge of the heart. And my dear devotees, it happens through practice. Many things, the prayerful attitude, praying to the Guru and Vaishnava and Lord. I remember one very nice statement by His Grace Gopi Pranadhana Prabhu. He used to say that before going to give a class or before going to preach, close your room and preach yourself. Close the door and preach yourself. And see, whatever we speak, we follow it. Then the person have the guts to say, and it touches to the heart of the devotees. So the knowledge of the head should transfer to the knowledge of the heart. So the aim, one of the aim of this Bhakti Shastri or Bhakti Vaibhav course is not just to get the marks or pass the exam or get the certificate, which is an essential part. At the same time, if Krishna wills and we get that strength to practice sincerely whatever we read, whatever we heard, at the right moment, as I gave the example of humility, giving a class of 2-hour class on humility, but at the right moment we fail. Just like what is that famous statement of Srila Prabhupada? The greatness of a person is estimated by how he reacts in provoking situation. So that is the practical point. So therefore, along with our education, information, training and certificate, we can strive to acquire these qualities what we read in the scripture, especially in Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam is not describe the activities of you and me. Activities of great personalities like Maharaj Prithu, Maharaj Dhruv, Yudhishthir Maharaj, Parikshit Maharaj. And they at the right moment, at the right time, they behave in a proper way. Practical example, what do you say?